Hello and welcome to Chart of the Day Cafe for Thursday, May 3rd, 2018. Read our disclaimer quickly. Trading stocks is a high level of risk and viewers should complete their own due diligence on any stock or underlying that they intend to own. 100% of the content of this video and communique is intended for journalistic and educational purposes only. This video and all indicators, strategies, and articles herein should not be construed as investment advice, not making any recommendations. Always for your further homework. Good morning, Sue here. Hope you've had a great week so far. Another interesting one in the markets. So with that, let's get straight into today's video. If you know me, you know I always start my videos off with a look at the Russell Index. And for that, I use the IWM, which is the ETF that represents the Russell 2000. And I like to step back and take a look at it on a five-year monthly time frame. I like that bigger picture look. I use the Russell as my proxy for the markets overall. As long as the Russell is moving higher, I'm adding new names to my watch list. When it's moving lower, I am being cautious and getting defensive. I just like to keep my processes pretty simple. And so I choose one index as my guide, and the one for me is the IWM. So we're looking at, I've taken away all my drawings. The only indicator on here is volume and this blue line, which is the 8-day EMA. We're looking at the monthly charts. I just wanted you to get a reference for how the candles have shaped up over the last several months. So here's January, which was the apex of this nice, smooth, long uptrend. At the end of January, we got that severe selling that brought us all the way back down here for February, all the way back up here for March, and back down here for April, and here we are for May. So tons of chop in this market. Very challenging. So here is how the candles are looking so far. So April, a little bit of an undecided candle with a wick at the top and a wick at the bottom, but a slightly bullish orientation, ever so slightly, because the body was white. And so here we are right here right now for May. I'm going to put my drawings back in. And this is long-term support resistance down here, ignoring it. Orange, ignoring this one as well, it's medium. Really paying attention to this zone right in here. The most important line on my chart is this black diagonal line. I'm going to take away this blue one because it's not really relevant anymore. We put the blue one in back in this area when price was chopping around and below this blue. And we said, hey, look, if the Russell's going to continue the uptrend, it's going to have to get not only over the black, but through the blue. So it is now through the blue, so I'm going to take that one away. And let's just focus on where we are right here, right now. So you can see on the monthly chart, we're just licking the underside of the trend line. This is the monthly orientation. Now I'm going to move it away to the two-year weekly. And as you can see, it on the weekly, it shows us up and over, trading in this little bit of a wedge pattern, a wick. But price action has been kind of soft. So I want to be extra cautious and careful in this area. Going to move it away from the 2 weekly to the 9-month daily. There's that same black line that's been so important. I'm going to actually zoom in a little bit. Here's the 9-month. This is my short-term area of support resistance down here. It's a long ways down. Really, the black line is the most important one here to me. Hope that's not too confusing for you. This is a guide going back all this way. But really the most important one for me right now is this black diagonal. So I want to see how price behaves around this area. And as you can see, if I zoom it in, we are up and over the blue, which is the 8-day EMA. Futures look to be a little bit higher. So today will be interesting. It's going to be the next couple of days, you would think, might decide direction. It just seems like it's been wonking around for a very long time, and something's got to happen pretty soon to give it some direction. But with price up and over the blue 8-day EMA, I am going to put a new chart forward for my watch list this morning. And the chart that I'm adding to my watch list this morning is Tusk Mammoth Energy Services Inc., ticker symbol TUSK, trades on the NASDAQ exchange. This is a relatively new company, so the chart only goes back a couple of years. They started in 2016. Let me tell you a little bit more about the company. They're in the petroleum exploration space. They're an oil field service company that operates in North America. If you know me at Chart of the Day Cafe, it's all about the scores underneath my charts. And Tusk has a really brilliant, really excellent value score, with a current forecasted earnings growth rate going forward of 52%. That's a wow. A current PE of 19.68, and it does not pay a dividend. So with that, let's get into the chart. Again, we're looking at the two-year weekly. Uptrend, increasing pitch to the trend. I like to see the 8-day EMA really rising here. It's resting in an area. Sky is blue, I call it. There's no overhead resistance, so the chart has never been higher. With those scores underneath it and in a continued rising market environment, I would think that Tusk Energy would start to rise from this area. We will see. But I like to see the volume ticking higher, the formation here. I'm going to move it away from, although it says 5-year weekly here, the chart only goes back 2 years, so it's really the 2-year weekly. I'm going to move it away from that to the 6-month daily. So you can see that we're at an area of support in this area here. And again, in a market that starts to show some strength, I like the way it is trading here and would expect Tusk Energy to start lifting and moving into my green circle. So just to be clear, I don't own it, but it's on my watch list as one that I really like, not only the price action, but the scores underneath it. Along with my new watch list pick, I also like to take a look at the sector that it's in, and for that we're looking at XLE, which is the ETF for the energy space, looking at the 5-year weekly chart. You can see that it kind of bottomed here in 2016, early 2016. It's been trending higher for the last 2 years. I'm going to zoom it into this area, so let's go 2-year weekly, because I want you to see the consolidation here through February, March, April, the lift, and the consolidation in here. So either this is consolidation to move higher, or the markets soften and we move lower, but I like to see this kind of a look here, and I would put a little line of support resistance right in this area. So should energy lift from here, Tusk has brilliant scores, is kind of displaying the same sort of look, and may lift with it. Also like to take a look at seasonality, and for that I always go to equityclock.com. I don't know if you can see, if I can get it in my screen, but this is an excellent site. Really like Equity Clock. We're coming to the end of seasonal favor here. I think it ends May 9th. So that this seasonal chart happens every year. I just like to look at this data point. But for me, the price on the chart is going to override the seasonality factor. But I just wanted you to see that because it's part of my process. As well, I also like to take a look at some articles on FinViz. And as you can see, this is a recent article from Zax featuring Mammoth Energy. It's a Zax number one strong buy stock. So it has that analyst favor. And so to recap, let's go back and check the boxes. I started today's video with a look at the IWM. I want to make sure the market overall is in an uptrend, with the IWM up and over the 8-day EMA on the daily chart. When I started filming this morning, it was the futures were flat to positive. They've now turned negative. So you want to be aware of that and the diagonal line that we're keeping an eye on the IWM. To me, in my way of thinking, I never want to buy anything when the overall market is soft, so be aware. But we looked at the sector that Tusk is in. XLE is in an uptrend on the 2-year chart and may be consolidating in this area for more lift. Tusk is in an uptrend on the 2-year chart, consolidating at an area of possible price strength, emphasis on possible. I don't know which direction it goes in. I just love the chart setup. Although it does not have a ton of volume, so I want to reiterate that. Enough for me, but it might not be enough for you, so you want to double check that. It's got a great value score, really high. Love the value score. It's got an excellent growth score with a forecasted earnings growth rate going forward of 52%. Does not pay a dividend, so the box is not checked. Does not have a 3-8 EMA daily cross, which I look for, but it's very close to getting one. Seasonality, we talked about that. Looks like seasonal favor for the energy sector ends around May 9th. It does have analyst support. It's a Zacks number one strong buy. And as we said, sky is blue. There's no overhead resistance should it get through this area. Current PE is 19.68 and earnings have not been announced yet. As a reminder, these videos go out every Tuesday and Thursday morning. I hope you find them helpful and thank you for watching.